Buying a home is one of the largest investments you will make in your life. That's why you'll want to know everything possible about the condition of your home that you're purchasing.
Here to help us through the home inspection process is Nancy Braun with Showcase Realty. Nancy, good morning. Thank you for joining us today.
Good morning.
All right, you have insider inspection tips to really help buyers through the process. First, let's talk about this. Does the buyer or seller pay for the home inspection?
Typically, the buyer will pay for the home inspection unless the seller is going to do an inspection prior to listing their home. But normally, it's the buyer will pay for their own inspections unless the seller is paying for the buyer's closing costs. So,
okay, so what are the typical costs of doing an inspection?
Well, they can range anywhere from about $400 to about $1,500. Depends upon how many inspections you're going to have. So it also depends upon the home. So you could have a general home inspector do almost everything. You might have a pool, so maybe a pool inspection. You might have a radon inspection. You can have a termite inspection, a structural engineer, roof inspection, furnace inspection, septic, well, it could add up.
Mm-hmm. Why is it so critical for a home buyer to get a home inspection done before they go under contract?
Well, that's the most expensive thing that you're going to buy probably in your lifetime. So you want to make sure that you know what the condition of the property is. And during the inspection, you're going to learn maintenance tips, and you're going to learn how to take care of your home and what specific things are specific for that home that you might need to keep an eye on.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here it is. I'm looking for an inspector. What should I be looking for, and what's going to delineate between who's a good inspector and what's a bad inspector?
Yeah, so, you know, inspectors are licensed, and they have to pass exams, and most have affiliations with national organizations. Your realtor is probably going to be your best advisor on giving you a couple choices on inspectors that they've used, that they've liked, and that they believe do a good job.
What are the most important inspections that should be covered? The most important things?
The home inspection, and in Charlotte, the termite inspection.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I also really urge all my buyers to do a radon inspection, because if you have radon in your house, you don't know it. It's an invisible gas, and it's deadly. So,
is there a different type of inspection for doing a single home and that of a condo?
It's the same. It's usually a condo's a little less money. It's not as complicated because usually the HOA takes care of the exterior, so it's really more on the mechanicals and the inside. But the home inspector will, you know, do either.
Mm-hmm. Should we be concerned about the inspection report that we get? Because sometimes that could be a little bit intimidating.
It is intimidating. It's very thick. And we actually, when we sit down to work with a new buyer, we'll show them an example of what a home inspection looks like, because they need to know what all the documents are going to be involved in the transaction. So we go through this enormous book and show them each. But the home inspection is full of a lot of detail, a lot of disclaimers, a lot of fluff, and maintenance tips. So you want to go to the summary page. Usually there's a page that just shows the items that are concerns that you need to address, but not be overwhelmed by the volume of it, because it's big for everyone.
Well, and that's where you can really help people through that process, because, you know, to you or I, it might be overwhelming, but you help us get to the important stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Go to
that
summary page. Yeah. So what kind of disclosures are required by law?
The residential property disclosure statement is required by North Carolina, and South Carolina has their own disclosure as well. And they have to disclose any known malfunction or defect that the homeowner, their seller, knows about.
Okay, now you said that you will sell a home for free if the buyer's not happy with it. Is that correct?
So we have a program that if my buyer ends up not loving their home in 12 months and they want to sell their home, I will sell it for free. They do have to buy another home with me.
Okay.
And that is the condition. And but other than that, you know, we want our clients to be happy.
That's generous. That is very, very generous.
Well, I've never had anyone exercise it, because they're always happy with what they buy.
Mm-hmm.
So, but it certainly takes away the fear element of getting into the wrong house.
The market is still really good right now. How long do you think it'll take to sell a Charlotte home? I know it kind of depends on the area and price point.
I think it's 34 days on the market now is on the average. Mm-hmm. It used to be much higher. So, you know, we have less than a 2-month supply in the Charlotte area. A stable market is 6 months supply.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a seller's market.
And then quickly, when an inspection report, if they find things that are wrong with the report, how quickly should the seller get on top of fixing those things?
Well, ideally, we would go and get estimates from contractors immediately, so we know what we're dealing with. Because Typically, a home buyer is going to be very worried about the items that are on the list, and they might think, well, it's going to cost $100 to fix a faucet, but it might be only a $10 fix. So we would like to get bids before we're even starting to negotiate whether the seller will do repairs or the seller could put up money towards the repairs, and then the buyer can get it done after closing.
Nancy, thank you. You're so good. Thank you so much. For a comprehensive buyer's agent home inspection cheat sheet, visit buyerbeware13.com. Buyerbeware13.com. Or you can call 704-997-3794. Again, 704-997-3794. Nancy and her team are happy to work with you. Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.